Hey guys, it's Chris. From legendary authors to men who helped make legendary discoveries and more, join me as I reveal 9 people who didn't die the way you think they did. Number 9, Edgar Allan Poe. Edgar Allan Poe is without a doubt one of the most well-known authors in history. And why is that? Well, because he was one of the dark authors, referring to how this particular group of writers went and wrote dark and foreboding tales of death, resurrection, and monsters. Poe himself was known for his stories and poems like The Raven, The Pit and the Pendulum, The Telltale Heart, and more. But what really made him stand out was that he was a deeply troubled man, one who had a very hard and complicated life that lasted right up until his death. Officially, his cause of death is unknown, which isn't too much of a surprise, given the medical standards in 1849 when he passed. However, because of his being found in another person's clothes, and very incoherent, people felt that he was the victim of a strange practice from those years called cooping. It sounds weird, but this was actually a form of voter fraud. Cooping at the time was when people were kidnapped, dressed in various sets of clothes, and sent to voting polls to be counted as votes multiple times. But more modern looks at his death paint a different picture. Mainly, some conclude that he may have had rabies, as he was showing various symptoms that agree with that diagnosis. Sadly, we'll never know the truth. This is why the death of Edgar Allan Poe has been attributed to things like disease, alcoholism, substance abuse, suicide, cooping, and more over the years. What do you think? Did you even know about cooping? Sounds like a ridiculous crime, but it was a real part of life 200 years ago. They even used it to force men to enlist in the army back in those days. Tell me if you think this kind of thing still goes on in other parts of the world, and after that, remember to subscribe if you haven't already. There are loads of amazing videos right here that you'll want to check out in the future, so hurry up and subscribe. Number 8. George Herbert. George Herbert has a very interesting place in history. Why? Because he was an earl who helped financially back the expedition that would lead to the uncovering of King Tut's tomb, one of the most important archaeological discoveries in the history of the world. However, when he did so, many warned him, including the legendary author Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, that he would be cursed by the tomb should he proceed with this. Not caring about the curse, Herbert went through with it, and after entering the tomb, he died a month later. This, of course, led to the belief of the curse of the pharaoh, especially when other members of the archaeological team also died as well via mysterious means. Here's the problem, though. While it's fun to blame a curse for this, the truth is much more simplistic and honestly kind of mundane. You see, George had gotten a mosquito bite while he was in Egypt, and when he was shaving, he accidentally hit the wound with a blade, and that caused him to get a skin infection. This in turn would lead to a bout with pneumonia, which particularly hit him hard, because Herbert had a rather weak immune system, and so thus he died. Now, on the note of the curse of the pharaoh, it was later revealed by the team that they'd made up the curse to deter grave robbers from ransacking the site when they weren't there. If you look at Egyptian history, they honestly don't talk about curses, let alone having them with the dead pharaohs. Number 7. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. When you think about some of the greatest musicians to ever write music, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart is obviously one of the best of the best. One of the reasons for this was that he was so gifted a composer, he wrote songs up until the very day of his death. Requiem was even the song that he made to honor the dead. But here's the thing, in terms of his actual death, there's a myth around what happened, and then there's what actually happened. The myth was that he was killed by a rival, which would later be put into a play and movie known as Amadeus, who stated that it was another composer, Antonio Sorelli, that killed him. Because of how entertainment can influence people, a lot of people felt this was true. However, it wasn't. Not at all. Mozart died of a medical condition. Now, as to what kind of medical condition, that is a bit up in the air. Researchers have suggested more than 100 causes of death, including acute rheumatic fever, streptococcal infection, trichinosis, influenza, mercury poisoning, and a rare kidney ailment. Then, in a 2009 study, a research team noted that there was a wave of deaths among men in Mozart's era around his age. So there might have been an epidemic going on, and Mozart may have gotten a streptococcal infection that took his life as a result. Number 6. Vincent van Gogh. Have you heard the term, an artist is most famous after they die? This statement came to be because many artists, composers, and visionaries are not fully understood in their time, and only after they're gone do they get the fame and success they deserve. A great example of this is the now legendary artist Vincent van Gogh. Vincent van Gogh was a genius with a paintbrush, but he was also a man with a very well-known case of mental illness. This led to the tortured soul moniker being placed upon him later in life. In 1890, Van Gogh was working in a field, and that very night, he came home with a gunshot wound to his chest. 2 days later, he was gone, and his brother Theo was by his side at the time of his death. It was confirmed that Van Gogh had shot himself, and thus led to the widespread belief that his mental illness had gotten the better of him, and thus he took his life. But was it really that simple? A new theory by modern historians notes that he might have been shot by a young boy who was known to antagonize him. It would have been an accident, obviously, and Van Gogh would have claimed responsibility for the incident to save the boy from trouble. The reason some think this to be true is that after the incident, both the gun and Van Gogh's paint supplies in the field vanished. What's more, Van Gogh was a religious man and did not approve of suicide. Even with his mental instability, that likely would have held firm. The truth, though, will likely never be known. Number 5. Napoleon Bonaparte. Once upon a time, before two world wars and the creation of a more unified Europe, in the not-too-distant past, France was a military powerhouse, and its most memorable general was none other than Napoleon Bonaparte. The short yet driven ruler of France conquered many lands and waged many wars before finally being dethroned and sent to a quiet life of exile on the island of St. Helena in 1815, where he would later die. Now, historically, it's claimed that he died of stomach cancer, which the doctors that treated him all agreed he had through analysis and knowledge that his family had this kind of cancer happen to them before. That being said, Napoleon had a different theory, one that stated the British poisoned him. This may sound like a desperate theory, but it's not as far-fetched as you might think. Well, because as long as Napoleon was still alive, there was a chance he could come back and fight even more, which he had done in the past. Also, modern tests of his hair did find arsenic in it. Arsenic is a deadly poison and would have easily killed him at the right levels. But since his full body cannot be exhumed due to the French government refusing to release it, we'll never truly know what happened. Number 4. Alexander the Great. There are many known warriors and conquerors of the world throughout history, but one of the most famous, infamous, and legendary was Alexander the Great, who helped conquer much of the Eastern world and brought a kind of unity through language and trade that is still felt in the world today. However, despite his grandness and his conquests, he died at the age of 32, which makes you wonder what would have happened if he'd lived longer. The common belief is that he died of malaria soon after arriving in Babylon. However, after he died, he showed no signs of decomposition for nearly a week, which has gotten certain people to wonder what really killed him. Mainly, they suspect that he might have had a condition known as Guillain-Barré syndrome, which is an autoimmune disorder that can lead to paralysis and death. The disease mimics certain symptoms of things like malaria and typhoid. So how does this tie back into the lack of decomposition? Simple. It may have taken so long for him to decay because he wasn't dead, just paralyzed by the condition. If he had lived in an age of modern medicine, doctors would have been able to figure this out and perhaps even treat him. Number 3. Joseph Stalin. Russia has played a major part in the recent history of the world, going back to World War I and even before that. But in the time of World War II, one man turned Russia into a new kind of power, one that could cause many deaths and terror for decades to come, and his name was Joseph Stalin. Stalin was many things: a ruthless man, a cruel and vicious leader, a paranoid man who executed his political opponents without mercy, and a heavy drinker. He was one who would sacrifice anything to win, and refused to accept defeat when he put his mind to something. That line of thinking would lead to many Russian deaths across World War II, and the rise of the Soviet Union. Yet despite his iron will, he apparently died of a stroke, as his attendants found him in his room with soiled clothes and in a slump. Stalin was partially paralyzed and had extremely high blood pressure, and he later vomited blood before dying. This seems like a pretty clear case of a stroke, right? However, Stalin was legendary for having many enemies, whom he promptly killed. But some did survive, and it's noted that he had many visitors before his apparent stroke. So since he was a drinker, some historians believe a political rival put something like a blood thinner in his drink, which would have potentially caused the stroke that killed him. If this is true or not is obviously up for debate, but it is possible. Number 2. Alan Pinkerton. The name Pinkerton was long used as a kind of special detecting and enforcement agent of the law, but originally it was a term used for spying because of Alan Pinkerton. This man used his skills to great effect and would help America set up detective agencies for many decades to come. In fact, he was the one who came up with the term private eye that is still used to this day. However, for being so smart, his death was apparently rather mundane. It was reported that he tripped and bit his tongue while walking his dog and later died of gangrene from the injury. How strange is that? Not the best kind of death. However, further studies say that he could have died of malaria, or that a stroke he had a year before might have had long-lasting side effects that led to his doom. Number 1. Pablo Neruda. Pablo Neruda was many things, including a poet, a politician, and a Nobel Peace Prize winner, believe it or not. His official death certificate lists his cause of death as cancer cachexia. This was odd for a simple reason. One of the main symptoms of that form of cancer, extreme weight loss, was not found in Neruda. Which would be very odd, as that's the main symptom. In fact, he was labeled as obese when he died. So how did he go out then? A common theory is that of poison. Neruda was an activist in Chile, and with a new regime in control of that country, led by dictator Augusto Pinochet, it would have been very realistic for him to get rid of a famous oppositional figure like him. Plus, in 2009, 6 men were arrested for poisoning the former Chilean president at approximately the same time that Neruda died. Coincidence? Or maybe something more? Thanks for watching. What did you think of this look at certain people you thought died one way, but honestly died in a completely different way? Which of these tales did you find the most surprising? Do you know any other famous figure who could have been on this list? Definitely let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe to World List, and we'll see you next time.